Have you ever wondered how track changes works in Microsoft Word? I am Chris Menard. I'm a Microsoft certified trainer and public speaker. Let me show you how track changes works right now. I have this sample Word document running that you can download from the description down below. To turn on track changes, you want to go to the Review tab at the top. When you select the Review tab, you have a tracking group, and that is where track changes sits. Next to the tracking group is the markup group, and next to markup is the comments group. I consider all three of these groups part of track changes, and you need to know how to use all three of them. I'm going to look at them in this short video right now. To turn on track changes, just simply come and turn on track changes, or you can do Control Shift E. I am using a Microsoft 365 account, so I'm in Word for 365. If you don't have this Copilot summary, just ignore that, please. When I turned on track changes, two things happened. One, it now has a gray background, so if I click it again, it's back to white. Click it again, it's turned on, it's gray. The second thing that happened, though, is since I'm using M365 in the top right-hand corner, next to the word share, it says reviewing. If I turn off track changes, it goes to editing. So you can also turn on track changes by clicking the drop-down for editing and selecting reviewing, track changes is on. Now, listed on the screen are the five items that track changes handles. Item number one, it handles insertions, that is put in any text or objects. Item number two is deletions, deleting text or objects. Item number three, formatting changes. This would be any font sizes, font types, colors, bold, italics, anything like that is a formatting change. Item number four is comments, adding comments to your document. And the fifth item that track changes covers is moved content. You move text or you move an object from one place in your document to another, that is a track change. Let's now look at a few different track changes. Let's start off with some insertions and deletions. I'm here, I don't like the word great. You can drag over it, but Chris Menard tip, just double click a word to select it. I'm gonna press the delete key. I am deleting the word great. If you notice over to the far left of my name is this little line. You can click this and notice it'll say hide track changes. Before I click it, in the markup group, all markup is selected. There's going to be four options here. We'll look at all four. So if I do click this, it goes from all markup to simple markup. Click it again, it's back to all. I could also just use it right here, just so you know right there how this works. All versus simple, right there. I'm going to add a word. So I made that corporate event. There's an addition or an insertion. I'm going to make this bold. When I select bold, over to the far right, that is called a balloon. That is not a comment. I haven't done a comment yet. That is called a balloon. I'll discuss balloons. Let's do one more. I'm going to select right here. Oh, before I do this, I'm going to make these bullets. Notice that markup line is increasing right there. Let's go to make these bullets, and there you go. There is a second balloon telling you what I did here. Concerning images, since I haven't done anything, I'm going to click at the bottom of the document. I'm just going to quickly insert an image I have stored locally. So insert picture. There is an image on the screen right there. Now, back to the review tab. One important note before I continue. We turned on track changes and we made changes, so they all got incorporated. If you turn off track changes, the changes that you use while track changes was turned on stay, which is great, by the way. You don't want them getting deleted or removed, but I will turn track changes back on. On our markup options right here, we've looked at all. Let's go back to simple. Simple markup keeps all the changes you should have, but it's showing you that you did do changes. We also have no markup. The line is missing. And finally, we can go back to our original right here. I'm going to go back to all markup. That is where I'm usually at with track changes turned on. Concerning show markup, please make sure you do these first two. These should always be checked, in my opinion. Concerning these balloons I have over to the right, we have three options for our balloons. Show revisions in balloons, right there. Go back to balloons. In line, which I don't care for, but I have, but you can use if you want to. I like this last one here, show only formatting in balloons. It is a matter of preference what you do with the balloons right here. If multiple people are accessing this document, I don't care if you're sharing it with OneDrive, SharePoint, maybe you're emailing it around, maybe you have a document management system. If multiple people are in here, you would see the names of the other people and you can specify whose track changes you want to look at right here. The reviewing pane, this is really simple. By default, it'll show up in two different places. When you click it, wherever you leave it is where it'll last show up. And you're saying, well, Chris, it showed up over on the far left. You could put it horizontally and it'll show up at the bottom. I do like the vertical. Click it to turn it on and off. Interesting that it's called the reviewing pane when you click it, but when the task pane appears, it's called revisions. It is showing you all the items that I did in this document. You can also move this if you still want to see it vertically, but want to move it over maybe to the right-hand side. You could move it, you can resize it, and you can close it. You can also close it with the X. That is your reviewing pane. I have not done any comments yet, so even though show comments is turned on, just to prove this, I've turned show comments off, back on, back off. My balloons are still sitting here because this is part of the track changes. I haven't done any comments yet. Let's just go ahead and turn it on though. Before I do comments, let's look at accepting and rejecting our track changes. I've got four different commands: accept, reject, previous, and next. Whatever you do, if you are sharing a file with multiple people and track changes is turned on, I encourage you to never, ever click accept all changes. You want to make sure you proofread the document. Now, if this file is just mine, I've seen it a million times. This is the one time I could say, hey, accept all changes, or even accept all changes and stop tracking. I'm going to do it. I did it for one reason. Undo still works in case you ever do that, just so you know that. Same thing with reject. Reject all changes. Undo still works. Now, this is what I do in real life. The default is to accept and move to the next, so you don't have to click on accept and move to the next. Before I do this, I'm going to click all the way at the top of the document. If you just want to see the changes, forget about accept and reject. Use next. It jumped to great. Click it again. It jumped to corporate. It's showing you I bolded that. So there is previous and next right there just to see what changes were made. Now it's time to accept and reject. I'm going to click on accept. It actually went to the word great. So it's showing me the first change. And actually, I'm going to accept that I deleted the word great. So I'm going to accept it. The word great's gone. I do want corporate in there. I'm going to accept that one. I made that bold. I'm making this up. I don't like it, so I'm going to reject the change. It moves down to the bullets. I like the bullets. I'm going to accept. And finally, adding an image or an object is a change, and I'm going to reject this one. I don't like that graphic on the screen. Word pops up. There aren't any track changes in your document. I click on OK. An important note, track changes is still turned on and it still says reviewing up in the top right corner for me. So if I start typing again, track changes is running. I wanted to turn them off. I could turn them off and now I could continue to work in this document without track changes. Let's take a look at comments real quick. For our comments, I'm going to highlight YouTube channel and I'm going to hit new comment. There is a comment over there. Great feature for M365. I can mention someone. So let's just say that I am sharing this document with Carol Wilson. If I do an @, there are people in my organization. I have blurred out all the email addresses, but they're okay with me showing their images. There's Carol. I could assign something to Carol by checking this box right here. She will get notified. But for right now, I'm going to keep this simple, and I'm just going to say mention the number of videos possibly. And I'm going to click on that, and there is a comment. People can come in here and like it. I can come in here and edit the comment. I can delete the thread. many options here. So once your comments are done, let me just add one more. Comments can be replied to. So you can have a running thread here. And then if you want to add and delete comments, we've already added comments, show comments on or off. And then finally, previous and next, just like the track changes, it jumps from the previous to the next. And you can delete all comments, or you can run them one at a time and delete them. I hope you enjoyed this video. Track changes is one of those items that a lot of people sometimes are unfamiliar with, and it is an awesome feature in Microsoft Word. I'm Chris Menard. My online training classes are listed down below. Have a wonderful day.